I'm Gernot Wagner, a climate economist at Columbia Business School. I keep a close eye on companies that are finding solutions to climate change. When you think of industries causing the most pollution, you probably don't think of the cement industry, but it's a massive polluter. Cement is responsible for 8 to 10% of all greenhouse gas emissions. Today, I'm in Oakland, California, meeting with Cody Fink, the founder of Brimstone, a high-tech cement company. Cody received a PhD in environmental science and engineering from Caltech. But Cody didn't just want to study climate change, he wanted to solve it. Now, Cody and his team of researchers believe they may have cracked the code to low-carbon cement. But is that really possible?
Good to see you. Good to see you. How are you doing?
So, what do you do here? Like, what's happening at Brimstone?
Let me start with the cement problem. Cement is the glue, and concrete is the building material. Right? So when you look at a building and someone might say that's a cement building, it's actually a concrete building. Yeah. Cement makes up 10 or 20% of concrete, and the rest is sand, gravel, and water. So without cement, concrete would just be a wet pile of sandy gravel. Well, the production of cement is responsible for about the same quantity of emissions globally as cars.
Cars and cement each account for about 8% of all CO2 emissions. But because cars burn fossil fuels, they get a lot more attention than cement.
And the interesting thing about cement, it is both just about the least funded part of the climate problem, and also the emissions don't have a whole lot to do with fossil fuels. And the majority of the emissions come from the rock that is used to make cement.
Limestone,
exactly. Yeah.
Nearly all the cement that's used today is made from limestone. Half of limestone's chemical makeup is CO2. So when you heat it in hot kilns, 50% of the rock is released as CO2 pollution.
So at Brimstone, we have been trying to figure out how to make a lower cost solution to produce cement without the greenhouse gas emissions in order to replace the existing process. Here's how our technology works. We start with a different rock that does not have any CO2 in it. These are rocks like basalt, like silicate rocks. And we extract the calcium through a chemical leaching process.
You're getting calcium from other rocks.
That's right.
Are they as ubiquitous as limestone?
They're more ubiquitous, actually. It's about 78% of the calcium in the Earth's crust is in rocks that we use, right? Silicates. So our rocks are more ubiquitous than limestone. Okay.
Yeah. You're getting rid of the limestone and you can eliminate those emissions as Brimstone.
Yep, exactly. Okay. Get rid of limestone, get rid of the CO2.
It's actually pretty incredible. Brimstone uses a completely different rock than limestone, yet it creates the same industry standard Portland cement that every major construction company uses. Different rocks, same cement, no pollution. Well, at least not from the rocks.
But you still need, right? You need the kiln, right?
Exactly, you still need energy. And in fact, you couldn't not use energy. And right now, energy of all types happens to be quite dirty. The remainder of the emissions depends on how clean energy gets. But we don't have control over all of those things. We just have control over the big problem in cement, which is the process emissions. Yeah, so basically this is our research facility where we do small scale experiments, right? Right when we start, we have ideas about, you know, how we want to make this process work, and we test them out at this scale. So this is the very smallest scale, like or the newest possible stuff in the facility. So the first step of our process is you take a rock, yep, and then you have to extract the calcium from it.
How valuable is this stuff?
Not.
No. Okay.
So if anything you use in the cement industry is valuable, mm-hmm, then you're gonna go out of business, right? And this here is the supplementary cementitious materials.
Brimstone isn't just producing Portland cement. It's also creating supplementary cementitious materials, AKA SCMs. SCMs are essential to strengthening concrete.
You take ordinary Portland cement, yeah, or the normal cement that everyone uses, mm-hmm, and you mix that with supplementary cementitious materials, yeah, which enhances the durability properties, mm-hmm, of the cement. They're actually the ash that comes out of a coal-fired power plant.
Okay.
So SCM,
okay,
is a necessary component of concrete,
okay,
that today is sourced from the coal industry.
Brimstone's SCMs come from the rocks they are already using.
And you get it out of this.
The critical part of Brimstone is that because we make co-products, we can use more of the rock. Okay. Whereas when you start with limestone, you automatically waste, you know, about 60% of the rock because it's just CO2 that goes into the air. And you can make the same thing out of lots of different ways. Mm-hmm. We make both Portland cement and supplementary cementitious materials.
Okay.
So our efficiency actually goes up.
Cody and his team may have cracked the code for low-polluting cement, but they say they'll only succeed if they can scale up fast enough to charge the same, or even less, than what the legacy cement companies are charging.
You need to have an economic incentive, because not everyone in the world is motivated by climate, and you know not everyone in the world you know, wants to pay more, even if they are motivated for climate.
Yeah.
And I can guarantee you that everyone definitely does not want to pay extra for cement.
Turns out.
Yeah.
No, nobody wants to pay extra because, frankly, nobody cares where the cement comes from as long as it holds up and the building doesn't fall down.
That's exactly right.
Okay, now, you might be the first one to have founded a company around this, right? But, you know, the Cemexes of the world, right, know that too. And why don't the big ones just do this, right? Use a different rock.
I mean, it's a good question. So, but the other part is, you know, the big cement companies, they've been doing the same thing for between 100 and 200 years. So they have, you know, shrank their R&D departments in order to cut costs because that's just the nature of a commodity industry. Like, it's the rational economic thing to do. So there's not a lot of innovation going on. Cemex and all the big cement companies, they are making money, but they're not making money to the extent of like a Google or something. In my view, it's all a risk. It's all a risk calculation.
Mm-hmm.
If you have an enormous amount of money laying around for investment because your margins are enormous, then it's not that big of a risk to try to do a moonshot thing. However, if you're like a commodity industry, then you do not have that kind of money laying around for a moonshot.
So Brimstone, a startup where there's hardly a coat or a tie in sight, is running mission control for the cement industry's moonshot. So far, Brimstone has raised more than $100 million from investors, including Bill Gates, but not from the big cement companies.
Put me in the mind of a cement executive, mm-hmm. one of the big ones, mm-hmm. right? The CFO of Cemex. Like, they're clearly trying to make money. They understand climate change is real. Actually, they have a commitment to decarbonize, right? Like every one of them does.
Yeah, and I would, maybe not a legal commitment, but they have a publicly stated commitment.
Don't they have all the incentives in the world to do what you do?
No. Okay. Yeah, so because these commitments are not legal commitments, like their only actual legal commitment they have is to make as much money as they possibly can for their shareholders. It is our belief that the incentive structure in the cement industry would not want to scale a new technology until the risk is essentially zero.
Bringing the risk of a new product down isn't an easy task, but Cody has a big idea. The government, starting with California's.
Okay, so about half the cement is being bought by governments.
Yeah.
And it's not just the federal government, although that's a big part too, of course, right? It's states and cities. You know, we're in a fairly liberal state here, right? So why not have this be the state that revolutionizes the cement industry?
Absolutely, right? So that is one of the policies that we're most excited about, right? It's called advanced market commitments, where a government, which consumes about 50% of cement,
mm-hmm.
Would say, hey, every year we buy 1 million tons of cement, you know, we will buy 500,000 tons of cement, and we could take that to a bank to get financing.
Yeah, now those advanced market commitments, you can do this with a government. You can also do it, let's say, with Microsoft, Amazon, Google. They're building data centers right now.
Exactly.
Left and right. And but why not use Brimstone cement?
Exactly. And one of the challenges, of course, is like in order to get to scale, in order to get to good economics,
mm-hmm.
you need to build a large-scale plant.
It's like chicken egg, right?
Exactly.
Like you sort of, you need to demonstrate that if you got the agreement, you could build the plant.
You need
to build the plant to get the agreement.
So we think that it is unless the government participates in advanced market commitments, we think that it is unlikely that you could sell an entire plant just to private industry.
Sure.
So it is our belief that we need to build at least one plant at full scale to show that the risk of building that plant is zero,
mm-hmm.
and then we can start licensing.
You're building one new one.
That's right.
And the hope is to replace the 3,000 existing ones.
Yes.
Walking around the lab, I can feel the enthusiasm and passion everyone has for this project. But the clock is ticking, and the challenge is massive. Cody needs to scale up this product, and quickly.
mean, the problem is getting bigger as we speak.
Exactly, the problem is getting bigger.
It's a race against time.
That's right. The question is, right, are we going to solve climate change?
Yeah.
And the answer is clearly yes. Clearly, we are going to, at some point, run out of fossil fuels, right? And we're going to stop polluting.
Right? Now, it turns out we are running out of atmosphere before we run out of fossil fuels. Yeah, right? That's the problem.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, exactly. The concentration will get way too high. And the question is, are we going to solve climate change on a time scale that is relevant to avoid, you know, some of the worst parts of
exactly.
And I, like, personally, I think yes. Ultimately, the things that are lower cost are going to be the things that can scale fast enough globally in order to solve the problem. So we're going to get the lower cost solutions scale fast, and then we're going to do adaptation, and that combination is going to solve climate change at a relevant time scale.
And now Brimstone is building a new cement plant. And if all goes well, it could be the first of thousands more.